The Community Historical Archaeology Project with Schools debuted the start of the Rio Grande Valley Civil War Trail at the Student Union Theater February 28th. The trail will bring to light the Civil War battles that were fought along the border lines in the Rio Grande Valley. More than 150 people showed up for the unveiling of the trail, having six speakers discussing different stories such as Tejanos in the War, African Americans' military experience in the valley, and archaeological findings in different counties with Civil War significance.
Today was a very important day for the Rio Grande Valley and for the CHAPS program, but really for the Rio Grande Valley because we launched today the Rio Grande Valley Civil War Trail. It is the first trail in the state of Texas devoted to the period of the American Civil War. It is also knits together an entire 200-mile region of the state that borders the Rio Grande River. Geographically, the trail runs from Brownsville to Laredo. There are some offshoots. And of course, that's important for community pride and economic development, but it's also really important because it really is looking at that time period from about 1846 to 1876. Because it is when this area was brought into the United States during the Mexican-American War, there were 53 lieutenants that served in the U.S. Army that 15 years later would be generals in the Confederate and Union armies. So they basically learned the art, if you will, of warfare here in South Texas. And it'll also be important for, as I said, communities and our students at the university to be able to learn about things.
The Civil War wasn't the only war that took place in the valley. Three battle sites from the Mexican-American War can be found in Cameron County.
There are three Mexican War battlefield sites in the Brownsville area. We are actually physically in charge of two, and a third one, we're just kind of an active steward. And, you know, tell the story of the beginning, the opening of the U.S.-Mexican War, which took place in, you know, pretty much May of 1846, which led to the peaceful occupation of Matamoros, eventually the invasion of Mexico proper, and in February of 1848, the signing of the Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo, which ceded over half of the Mexican territory, which means California, New Mexico territory, into the United States. So I'm saying the events that started here, that in our backyard, the events where we still have battlefields and places where you can come see it, changed the face of the North American continent and forged forever the relationship between our two young republics.
Reenactors set up tents and living areas to replicate a military campsite so people could see how soldiers would live during the 1860s. They also show different weapons and accessories that soldiers from both sides used during the war.
Yeah, people don't know about stuff, and they don't know if Civil War ever got down here. There was a whole bunch of battles, and that's what this trail is about. There was, dozen at least battles all along the river, and there was people on both sides of the river. Our history here along the river is real interesting, and it's more intertwined with the people across the river than what we realize, because they just don't teach that stuff. But there was sympathizers for both sides in the Mexican military population across the river, and that's part of what this trail is about, and the history that you read about is how troops came from Mexico and helped the American troops and vice versa. A lot of the Confederates fled to Mexico because the rumor was they were all going to be put in prison after the war ended, and they went over there and helped fight against the French to get the French out of Mexico. When you start reading about it, you just go, oh my goodness, there's a lot of stuff here.
For more information about the Civil War Trail, click on the links in the description below. Don't forget to subscribe to the Pan American YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, and follow us on Twitter. For the Pan American, I'm Michael Aguilar.